So let's have a word of prayer, if you would, just bow your heads. Father, we thank you for your grace. Your grace is sufficient. And you're able to cause all grace to abound toward us so we will have sufficiency in everything. Father, we confess that you are the strength of our lives. And every good gift, every perfect gift comes from you. Father, we thank you that we are all that you declared us to be. We will say and affirm that greater are you that is in us than he that is in the world. Lord, it's you that worketh in us your will and the do of the good pleasure. It's you that worketh, that effectually worketh in all of them that believe. Father, we thank you. We receive the word of God. The word is life to all of us. Father, the word of God is the word of God. And we thank you, Lord, for the word, because your word will not return void. It will always accomplish whatever you have designed it to accomplish. Lord, your word is life to them that find it. It's healing to all of our flesh. The interest of your word, give it light. Give it understanding to the simple. Father, we thank you that your word, hallelujah, is forever settled in heaven. Your covenant, you will never break it, neither alter the word that has gone out of your mouth. You are faithful to you that calls, and faithful are you that will do it. Father, we give you praise and we give you praise, glory, and you will never suffer your faithfulness to fail. Your counsels of old are all faithfulness and truth. Father, we thank you and we give you praise in Jesus' name. Everybody just say in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I'm just going to talk about, I would say, the greatest lesson that the redemptive work of consciousness has given us. And we're going to focus our attention around the redemptive work of Christ during this season, this period of time, and we want to pass out lessons because we understand that many of you are not involved in Bible study, and it's a real disadvantage when you are not able to get all of the information, all of the teachings that we do on Wednesday night. And even on Sunday morning, Sunday schools, unfortunately, everybody just said, unfortunately. That's not what I want to say, but do let that go. It's unfortunate. Praise God. And, but we always endeavor to get the information dispensed in any way that we need to. So, as a result of not everybody not being in Bible study, I put together a meditation book that will capture practically everything that we have taught for the last several months. And during the consecration, we will capture practically everything that we have taught when it comes to the redemptive work of Christ. We're going to have that in our Bible study and going to require you to work through that, and this is going to be turned in to Pastor Hill, because I have to give an account of your souls, and I feel so terrible sometimes. I say, Lord, what kind of account can I give? And you hold me accountable, when, you know, so I'm just going to put it all on you. If you're not here for a Bible study, then I'm going to put a sub-study in your hands where you can work out, you can work through, and you can recapture practically everything that we have taught when it comes to redemptive realities. Anyway, I'm not going to be excited about that, but amen, praise God. Well, that means work, doesn't it? It means work. All right, I want to talk about the greatest revelation in the Bible in terms of when it comes to redemptive realities. It's going to be talking about righteousness. Amen. The righteousness of God. And we're going to use several scriptures. And we are mindful of the time because the children are here today, and they don't have the endurance that some of us have, probably not as much as some of us. But anyway, we're going to give you a few scriptures to start with, and because I feel that the greatest achievement when it comes to spiritual achievement that we have ever witnessed or we have ever, that has ever been manifested or revealed is the fact that God has reconciled us back to Himself through Christ. The reconciliation of the mankind, the reconciliation of man, that's the greatest achievement. And it was achieved over 2,000 years ago. Amen. How we were reconciled back to God. So I want to start with 2 Corinthians 9:21. And I always say the greatest conquest that we can witness throughout the Word of God is the conquest that Jesus won over Satan. He defeated Satan. He delivered us from the power of darkness. He broke Satan's dominion. He bruised the rulership, the head of, he bruised the head of the rulership, which was Satan. And he recaptured, regained, and he restored or recovered the dominion that was lost to Adam through conquest. He had to defeat him. And he had to defeat the hierarchy of hell, principalities and powers and rulers of darkness. But he brought them all to naught, defeated them, paralyzed them, and left them stripped of their authority. And he gave that authority to each one of us. So being reconciled back to God is a major achievement that we went over point by point, scripture by scripture. All of this will appear in your homework and how it applies to you today. How it applies to you today. The third greatest victory is the restoration of everything that was lost through Adam. Amen. The scripture says all things are yours. He's given you everything. We started out with everything, and all of that was restored. Amen. Through Adam. So we inherited. We are heirs of God, joined us with Christ. Jesus inherited when he was raised from the dead. He turned around and gave that inheritance to us, restored it back to us, because in Adam we lost everything, but Jesus, amen, became poor that we might be rich. He came back to restore everything that Adam took away. So we have scriptures for all of this. Amen. Y'all gonna love these scriptures. We have scriptures for all of this. The three greatest events that believers have ever been given, has ever been revealed to believers. Amen. The fact that we were reconciled back to God through Christ, and there are a host of scriptures. We can't get into all of the scriptures. But when you look at those scriptures and see how Christ reconciled you back to God, you just shout. Redeemed us from the curse of the law. Delivered us from the power of darkness. Translated us into the kingdom of God. How we can have remission. Under the old covenant, Brother William, when they teach this, old covenant things that the fellowship depended upon. In other words, fellowship with God, you had to go through what? The sacrificial system, right? They had three sacrifices for fellowship. Under the old covenant, they had two for trespass sins. And then had one big deal every year, the atonement, where the high priest officiated. And the other priest, Aaron's priest, they officiated, amen, during the other times. This was a daily thing that they offered up these sacrifices. Amen. But we have a better covenant. We have a better, amen, based on better promises today. Amen. How many would like to go back to the old system? If y'all won't praise God and appreciate what God has done for you, you might as well go back to the amen, killing calves and ox, amen, turtle doves and goats. If they don't praise God, hallelujah. Because that's what Jesus is, what high priest ministry is all about now. And one thing I like about the whole thing, and when you look at that we've been reconciled back to God, bought with the price, we've been restored back to our original place in Christ. Does anybody have it happen? What is man that thou art mindful of him? And the Son of Man that thou what? Visited him. Made him just a little lower than the angels. That means lower than the angels when it comes to physical. Amen. Strength. But positionally, we are what? We are higher than angels. Am I right? Amen. Made him a little lower than the angels and crowned him with glory. Lord, how many believe that you've been crowned? That's what the reconciliation, restoring you back to fellowship is all about. Amen. The same blessing, the same dominion and honor and blessings, amen, that went with the first Adam, that Adam was given initially, amen, was restored back through the second Adam, Christ. How many glad that Christ restored us back? Amen. If you want to get a good picture, a good picture, a vision of what you are to be and what you are in the mind of God and what God wants you to be in reality, amen, just look at the life of Jesus. Amen. Look how he walked in righteousness. Amen. Walking in righteousness, that doesn't mean that he had all right, just right actions. Amen. But that is a part of walking in righteousness, which we call holiness. Amen. Right actions, but also is what? Is doing the works. Jesus said, the works that I do, they are not what? Mine. Amen. He went about doing good, what? Healing all of those that were what? Oppressed of the devil, for God was with them. And the same works that he did, we ought to what? Do also. How many believe that? Same works, the same works, because Jesus was a what? A revelation of God. It was what God really had in mind for what the first Adam. The first Adam came short. Amen. The second Adam did what? Amen. He walked it out. How many glad that he walked it out? Let's praise the Lord. All right, let's turn to 2 Corinthians 5:21. That is the first scripture that I'm going to do, and we'll move from that. For he had made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Amen. Let's all repeat that together. For he had made him to be what? Sin for us, who what? Knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Okay, I want you to turn to to Colossians, because if you understand the greatest achievement that we have ever witnessed in history was how Jesus went about reconciling man back to God, acting as man's mediator, amen, coming in the form of flesh so that he can relate to humanity and he can walk out, amen, what it means for us to as believers to follow his steps, God's intention, what God had in mind when he created Adam. Jesus walked it out in reality. And how many understand what I'm saying? Jesus actually what? Walked it out. Did he face Satan? Did he conquer him?
Yes.
Amen. Did he, amen, spoke to those that were sick and diseased and infirm? Amen. Did they get healed?
Yes.
Amen. He exerted what? The authority, the original authority that what? God had initially given to who? Adam. Amen. Seeing the ways, obeyed his voice. Amen. He spoke to trees. Amen. Sister Holman, amen. Amen. He spoke to a fig tree and told the fig tree to what? To die. And did it die? He began to dry by the roots. Amen. That's what it means to kind of walk in righteousness. Amen. You're bold, you're confident. Amen. You know what you're doing. You know who you're hooked up with. You know your what relationship with what? Your Heavenly Father. And you're not doing it in your strength anyhow. Amen. You're hooked up with what? Omnipotent. How many glad? Amen. The battle is not ours. The battle is the Lord. Amen. We are one with him. He that is joined unto the Lord is what? One flesh. Amen. Turn to somebody and say, you're one flesh with God. You're hooked up with him. You're united with him. And that's what righteousness is really all about. Jesus, amen, dominated it. The winds of the waves spoke to the winds and told the winds, oh, obey my voice. Do what I say, do it. Amen. Originally, God had meant for man to dominate all of the works of his hands. What is man? They're mindful of him. Who is he? Amen. God visited him, crowned him with what? Glory and honor. Amen. And gave hate and caused him to have what? Dominion. Amen. Lift your hand and say, I have dominion. See, that dominion was restored back through what? Jesus' conquest. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Amen. He defeated who? Slew foot. And took away the armor that he trusted in. Boy, he left them what? Praise God. Trembling in their boots. Spoil all of the hierarchy. Power. Principalities and powers and rulers. Brought them to what? Zero. Took back the dominion. Amen. Praise God. I'm glad he took that dominion back. That's what we call authority. Lord, how many glad you have God? Jesus took it back. Hey, hallelujah, hallelujah. He defeated what? Principalities and powers and made a show of them openly. One scripture says he has delivered us from the power of what? Darkness. Translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we now are redemption. Woo, glory. Bought with a price. How many glad you were bought with a price? Yeah, that song, Jesus paid it all. Yes, yes, all to him we owe. Jesus walked it out. Amen. He was him. This is what Jesus said. Me and my Father are one. And that's what actually righteousness is. It's your oneness with God, possessing the very life nature. Amen. Of what? The Father God. God working through you. Amen. Jesus said, me and my Father, we are all one and the same. When you see me, you see what? The Father. Amen. Praise God. And I believe that that oneness, amen, that was the reason why Jesus had all of the boldness. He wasn't afraid, amen, to speak to dead Lazarus after he had been dead for days. Amen. He approached that just as simple. Amen. Just as calm and comforting and as bold, as sure-footed as he could be. He said, amen. My Father, before you pray, said, Father, I thank you that you've already heard it. Wouldn't that be good if we had that comfort? When you enter into prayer, Lord, I thank you that you've already. That's what the word said, the confidence that we have in it. If we ask anything according to his will, he hear with us. And if we know that he hears us, then we know that we have the petition of the things that we desire him. You already have it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The moment you want, you believe it and receive it and begin to act on it. Hallelujah. How many say praise the Lord? How many glad that Jesus always hears us pray? And that is the reason why he's at the right hand of the Father. Amen. He's there. What? Handling our petitions. How many glad? He's there. And see, in the end, when Jesus what, ascended to the Father and took his place at his right hand, it did end when he rose from the dead, when he defeated Satan, amen, and what came forth with all authority in heaven and in earth. Thank you, Lord. Amen. That wasn't the end of our redemption. Amen. How many glad he went further? Amen. Praise God. Woo, Lord, I'm just getting so happy. Woo, Lord. And he took the blood that he had shed into what? To the heavenly holy of holies and offered that blood and seal our redemption. And then he sat down. How many glad he took that seat at the right hand of Father to act as our what? At identify with our problems, because the Bible says he was tempted as we were. He went through life exposed to all of the what? Temptations and everything that man has to confront. But he did it all without sin. And he gave the devil a run for his money, didn't he? Amen. The devil never tripped him up. He emerged walking through life. Perfect. Did no sin. Woo, Lord. My God, by the guile found in his life. Amen. He qualified to be our redemption. Amen. Jesus is my champion. I don't know about y'all. Hallelujah. The Bible says they are all of these things we are what more than I. Lord, see, that's talking about. That's the reason why I'm forming these lessons, because I want y'all to get at the crux of y'all's our problem. The problem is that many times spiritual realities haven't become real to us. I mean, we're already victorious. In the mind of God, amen, we have already arrived. In the minds, that's the legal aspect of our religion. That's not reality for everybody. Amen. That's the reason why we want you to get these lessons and begin to start confessing them. Amen. The little yellow book, a brown book, a beige book that we call the Breakthrough Confession Manual. Amen. Some of y'all don't know what I'm talking about, so I know where you are. It was a sister yesterday that I met with. She said, Pastor, I'm going through half of my, you gave me one of those big ones. See, I had one with two-sided, it's much smaller. Then I had one-sided, it was much larger. And she had one of those one-sided. So that's a big, fat book. And she said, Pastor, I'm halfway through my big, fat book. That book is talking about having a servant's heart. It's talking about humility. And see, this is what's so good. Y'all don't understand what you have in your hand. If you miss all of the lessons that we taught on humility, you can go back and read the entire sector on humility and having a servant's heart. You will recapture everything that we did. Now, it's between me and you and those folks. How many didn't know humility was in there? Between me and you and the dating folks. I won't tell. I see you skip to raise your hand. Praise the Lord. My time is almost up now. That's the reason why all of you that haven't had a chance to sit under this teaching on new creation realities, we're going to pass out these lessons, and we're going to set a time that we can kind of give it a shot, try to get you all together to go over it. You can understand it a lot better if I go over it. But what I want you to understand is that in the mind of God, and the legal thing that we always refer to is referred to the same thing. In the mind of God, everybody, that's scripture 2 Corinthians 5:21, he became sin for us. All right, let me just read another one. Who knew no sin, that we through his what? That he might be what? That we might be what? Made what? Righteous. Okay, now I want you to look at Colossians 1. Started there in verse 21. I guess this deal up here is working right now. Amen. But Colossians 1, I want you to read that, because these are all dealing with Christ being made sin, and as a result of being made sin and suffering and completing and pleasing God, actually meeting every requirement, every demand that God had placed on our redemption. After he had paid the price in full, the Bible says he was quickened and he was made alive. He was quickened and he was made alive. I mean, this scripture is going to bear out. But I want you to turn there. We're going to read Colossians 1, verse 20. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself. By him I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. And this is the part I like. And you that were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now have he what? Reconciled. All right, let's keep on reading that. In the body of his flesh, through death. I mean, that was spiritual death, and that was natural death. This is what that's natural. To present you what? Holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. I want to stop there. If ye continue in the faith, grounded and settled. Now, after you get a revelation of what Christ has done for you and all of the provisions that he has made, how he has reconciled you back to God, that's the first big point. How he has what? Defeated Satan and made, amen, and brought him to what? And neutralized or paralyzed his powers. That means restoring back to you your dominion. Amen. And thirdly, restoring everything else that was lost. And giving you a great inheritance, what the Bible says, all things are yours. Amen. As a result of that, once you get a revelation of that, you're going to be way ahead of the game. You want to get what God says about it in a legal aspect. In other words, I want to say this. When Jesus actually sat down on the right hand of the Father and had God had become sin. Everybody said, become sin. He was made sin without sin. After he had what? Defeated, slew for it. And after he had been what? Quickened or made alive or born out of death. Born out of death. Now, this people don't understand this. When you get a revelation, because when you get a revelation of things, they really begin to articulate them and express them. Amen. It's going to what? It's going to clear up a whole lot of issues in your life. I don't know of anything that can turn around people that have been exposed, amen, to things, to bizarre situations. Yesterday I was mentioning and I was counseling with a couple, and they had witnessed actually the abuse in their home. In other words, the father was very abusive to their mother. And it was terrible. And I was recalling to them that we had dealt with a couple years ago, which the husband was never saved, and he gave the wife a hard time because she was a very faithful member, very dedicated, very committed, prayer lady, and a woman of faith. And he took her through a whole lot of changes. Infidelity and all the bit, the drugs and all of the bit, because he had suffered a terrible, 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 terrible childhood. He had seen his father, amen, shut down, I believe, in cold blood. Shut down in cold blood. And he was never able to kick it, and he couldn't see any way that particular experience, you know. Personal experience, there's a whole lot of things that contribute to the way that we think and the way that we are. See, our limitations that we have are not just by chance. They are caused from what? Environmental things that we have what? Been exposed to in the past. Amen. Y'all wonder where I'm going with this? Just keep on listening. Amen. Praise God. And, amen, when people have suffered even sexual abuse, amen. They have been what? What you call it? Taken advantage of. Violated. These are serious things that register very deeply in the subconscious mind. It's not hard. It's not easy to get over. There are some things that are just almost impossible to get over without God. And that's the reason why the experience that people go through in life probably register and do more to shape their beliefs than any other experience.
stress that they have to deal with. You have the environment, you have what? Authority figures that usually damage a whole lot of folk. You know, believe some of us was damaged due to authority figures. I don't know about your parents, if they didn't wear the word, probably got might make them more damage than you think you got. Glory, people talking down on you and calling you everything but a child of God. And yeah, I brought you into this world, I can take you out. Y'all hear some stuff like that from authority figures? Glory, hallelujah. And a lot of people get mixed up with a lot of that crap that they're exposed to through authority figures, and sometimes they out with the boys, out with the girls, out with the friends, and they hear all kind of what? Junk that really what? Trash their minds. And more when our environment gets through with them, and when our authority figures get through with us, and when our friends and acquaintances and our running buddies, our drinking buddies, our dope dealing buddies, and all of these people that we would hang with talking all of that stuff, negative stuff, amen. And but let me tell you, there's another thing that you can experience which has more effect, negative effect, or you can have a positive effect, is the things that you experience in life. Praise God, the things that you experience. And that's the reason why you talk to people, they saw their mother or their father even abuse each other. They saw somebody shot down in cold blood. They were involved, or they were involved in a fatal accident that took out somebody that was close and dear to their heart. Amen. But that is the reason why God wanted us to have a way that we can reverse back and take back everything that was lost. How many glad that God has fixed it where everything can be what? Restored back. Jesus came to mess us up, Jesus came to what? Amen. The devil came to what? He's the one that comes to what? Steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said that I am come that you might. The devil wants to what? Mess us up. But Jesus came to what? Now, I'm going to tell y'all this, y'all might not accept it. I believe that if the redemptive work of Christ, if it won't straighten up everything that was messed up and get at the root of every problem that has what? Amen, been what? Deposited in your life. I believe that, amen, it wasn't worth Jesus going to the cross and dying for him to come and sin for. Where sin abound, everybody said where sin abound, grace what? Doth much more. Amen. One thing about Jesus' work, it can release you from what? All of those dead works of the past. All of those what? Bad experiences. Everything, whatever the environment put on you. Whatever the authority figures, amen, how they twisted the truth and amen and failed to what? Couldn't articulate the truth, I didn't do it. And the bad experiences that you have gone through, Jesus came that we might have what? Life, and that we might have it what? More abundantly. How many can say praise God?
Praise God.
Alright, now the way Jesus has designed for our beliefs to be reversed is through some experience with him. In the Old Testament, when God wanted to, for instance, Moses had the problem, he said, I can't answer your call. I'm not capable of what carrying out this assignment. He said, I've got some what? Problems. I've got some what? Limitations. And my problem is what? I can't talk. I can't communicate, articulate my thoughts like what? Like my brother Aaron. And God said, hey, like you, I'll be with your mouth. You ain't got no excuse. I'll be with your mouth. I'll anoint you. I'll give you power. Hey, my ability to talk. Every time And he had a barrier, a limitation that he couldn't get beyond. God always enabled him to what? And he took him through some type of experience. Showed him a vision. Let him hear the voice of an angel. Let maybe a dream or, I mean, when Joseph had that dream, amen, all of the things that he suffered in the future, he didn't want, he didn't face. Because he had what? He had heard from God. Amen. And the thought of him not what, ascending to the what? The highest position in Egypt other than Pharaoh. That didn't even cross his mind because he had what? Heard from God. So what I'm saying, an experience from God, whether it's vision or dream. Everybody say vision or dream.
Vision or dream.
Say it again.
Vision or dream.
Now, many times people in the Old Testament, they had visions. We have them now. Amen. They had dreams. And that was the thing, amen, that enabled them to get beyond whatever barrier, whatever limitations, whatever hindrance, whatever the devil had placed in their path, that they, amen, that enabled, that hindered them from answering the call of God. But under grace and truth, how many can say grace and truth? Hallelujah. You know, we have a powerful, amen, the weapons of our warfare, they are not what come. Oh, Lord, they are what mine. Said they are mine. Now, the greatest revelation you have is a revelation of who we are in Christ. That can get it. I mean, I don't care how bad it is. Y'all heard Brother Scales about 2 weeks ago, right? He was about as bad as you can get in the natural. But what changed him, he came to visit us about a year after he was delivered. He said, by 3 hours every day, he would pray in the Spirit. Pray in the Spirit. That's what I'm speaking about. Spiritual spirit. Prayer. Because something happens when you pray. And another thing he did, he always made a point that he would go out and witness to somebody every day. I've seen him time and time and time again on street corners, flagging and waving people down just to get in the word about what? How good Jesus was. And those were experiences. So that took him from what? The guttermost? Amen. I always said nature form you, school inform you, and what did I say? Mother Nature form me, school inform me. The devil deformed me. And I went to school and got transformed. I went to Jesus and got what? Transformed. Nobody can what? Transform me but Jesus. Amen. And not only can he what? Transform, return you from darkness to light, remit your sin. How many know when you come to Jesus, all of your sins are what? Completely wiped out. You don't have no past. Amen. He delivered you from what? The power of darkness, and he translates you into the kingdom of his what? Dear son, my time is almost out. But the thing about it, he not only remits your sins, but he gives you courage to what? Resist it and to overcome and to what? Live a life free and what? Separated from it. And also, amen, the same word, the grace of God will always give you the ability to overcome every handicap, every deep-seated, rooted what? Problem that you have what? Experienced at the hand of the enemy. How many believe that the devil is a liar? His works have been completely what? Defeated. Jesus is what? Lord. Amen. And no weapon formed against us can prosper. When the Bible says that Jesus what? If you continue in my word, you shall know the truth. And the what? Truth. Somebody say that with me. And the what? How many believe it pertains to your emotions, your hurts, and all of your, praise God, the injury that you experience internally and externally by the hands of the enemy? If any man be in Christ, he is a what? New creation. All things have what? Passed away. And behold, what? All things become new. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Now, as I was going to say earlier, that all the works that were done through Christ are good for all humanity today. How many can say amen?
Amen.
He died for the whole world.
Yes.
Now, since the whole world is what saved, in the mind of God, the price for man's redemption has already been what? Paid for. How many can say amen?
Amen.
It's up to us for what? To receive the finished work of Jesus. How many going to say yes? Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. How about that? That's the reason the Paul said, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, and what? Believe it in your heart. Amen. If thou shalt believe in thy heart, or confess it with your mouth, and believe it in your heart, the Lord Jesus, thou shalt be what? Saved. So he begins with your deliverance, began with what? Confession in your mouth. Confess it, the Lord shall be. Then you're going to say, praise the Lord.
Praise
say,
Lord.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I've been delivered. Satan's power over me has been what? Broken. I've been delivered. Come on, say it with some conviction. That's what boldness. Say it with confidence. That's the thing that causes Satan to back off. It's your bold confession. How many can say that? Your bold. How many going to be bold? That's the reason why I think that every promise, all the provisions that we have received, that Christ has atoned for and made it possible for us to regain, they are going to be received one by one as we will confess their reality. One by one. Amen. Praise God. That's the reason I have to go back. Amen. Being delivered from Satan's dimensions. Read every scripture. Just read it. Amen. All the name. Amen. Amen. Read it. As you begin to what? Affirm it and confess it, then it begins to resonate in your heart. Amen. That's how the changing takes place. It has to resonate. It has to register. It has to impregnate your what? Spirit. It has to become alive. Amen. Scripture says, Romans 8, 2, 7, amen. Amen. If the Spirit, amen. Amen. For the law of the Spirit has made me what?
Free.
See, that scripture over in Colossians, if you continue, that means what? You don't have to keep on what? Confessing, affirming. You have to take every inch. Wherever you put your soul, the sole of your feet, if it's a tread on it, it's going to be your land. That's what the word of God said to what? Joshua. Hallelujah. And that's the reason why it says to the candidate, if you continue in the gospel, you have to what? Stick with what? The reconciliation scriptures. The conquest scriptures. Amen. You got to, amen, praise God. That has to register, resonate in your spirit that Satan is defeated. Y'all looking around, amen, y'all gazing around, hallelujah. Satan is what? Defeated. I want you to say, can you fix your mouth? You know, sometimes people are afraid. They don't have that boldness. It's fear. They won't boldly say, I've been delivered, because they have something going on in their life that they can't get rid of. Yes, I can't say that. But the legal part has to become what? In order for the legal to become what? Vital, or become a part of your experience, you're going to have to what? You're going to have to agree or affirm the legal part. In the mind of God, I'm free.
Yeah.
You don't have to be free in reality, but you never will be free. Amen. With the eyes of, faith can see, the hand of God can reach out and receive. How many can say amen? You're going to have to keep saying that until what? It's written, our registers on the screen of your imagination. Until you can see it. You have to see it before you can actually see it in reality. Is that right? And you do that by what? Hooking up with God. Affirming. Saying what God says about you. In the mind of God, you are already free. In the mind of God, you are already delivered. In the mind of God, you are already blessed with every spiritual blessing. Jesus. Never mind on God. You have been one. Amen. All things are yours. Amen. Everything that pertains unto life and unto godliness, already, legally, in the mind of God, they are yours. Are you going to reach out? Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And begin to what? I agree. Yes, Lord. All things are mine. I am blessed with every what? Spiritual blessing. You have. Well, I'm all over my head. I ain't scared of old school, but y'all scared of. But Bible says, fear not, be not dismayed. I'm your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you. You have a blood covenant relationship with God. Is that right? He will never what? He'll never leave you nor forsake you. And if you get off track, that's the reason why he's up there at the right hand of the Father. Amen. Grace is the sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ. Amen. And the present word that he is what now administered to us through the Holy Spirit. See, sin ain't no problem no more. Jesus defeated it. The Bible says if you sin, you have an advocate. He's your intercessor. He's the one that what? Hooked your back in. In the Old Testament, they had to offer those more sacrifices for their fellowship when they trespass. But under the new covenant, I have a telephone in my bosom. Hallelujah. I have Jesus at the right hand of God making intercession for me. He is praying for me at all times. Hallelujah. How many know that you can make it? Amen. If the Spirit of the law of life in Christ Jesus has made me what? Free. The reason why you're free is because of what Jesus has done and what Jesus is what? Now presently doing on your behalf at the right hand of the Father God. He is for me. If God didn't spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall we not? Because of his achievement in reconciling us back to God, his conquest over Satan, and him restoring back to everything that was taken. We have a great inheritance and we've been blessed. And that is the reason why the name of Jesus is the name above what? All names. If you know what's behind the name, the thing that the way that he got it through his achievement. He got it because of his what? Lift your hands and say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
call up all our sister. You're right.
There is no trick like the Lord, Jesus. No, not one. No, no, not one. Lord, that's could heal all my soul's diseases. No, not one. No, no, not one.
Now, henceforth, and forever. Everybody said together, praise the Lord.